I'm Ron Patterson with Utah State University Extension in Carbon County. We're talking about killing Russian olive trees, and so I'd like to discuss a little bit about the chemical we use and our application method. Some of the chemicals that are labeled for cut stump type treatment would be just as effective. We've found with Russian olive that glyphosate products, Roundup or kills all high yields, kills all, there's a number of products that have the glyphosate in them. And that's what we've used, and it's been very, very effective. The aquatic label has been just as good as the non-aquatic label. So we have been very successful year-round using glyphosate products to kill Russian olives. I'm sure that the Garlon and some of those others, we're doing some other trials on those. We're testing those to see if they're just as effective, but we've had year-round kill using 41% undiluted glyphosate in the to treat the stumps. Now our application method is a little bit unique. We use a livestock dosage syringe, just set it to 1 milliliter per click, and that way I can tell exactly how much I'm putting on. It doesn't take very long to do it that way. Some people like to do the little spray bottle thing, but the accuracy isn't probably there. You're not sure how much you're putting on. So we put down our chemical with a livestock syringe. So if we've got a 4-inch tree stump, I'll put 4 milliliters of chemical around the cambium rings, the outside sap rings of the tree. There's no point in treating in the middle. So we'll come in close and take a look and show how the application method works with using the livestock syringe. All right, so we see here we've got this tree that we just cut down. The growth, the food coming from the leaves down to the roots come down through this layer, and the water coming from the roots up to the leaves comes through the xylem tissue. So you got the phloem and the xylem tissue. The active phloem and xylem tissue is just around the outside of the tree. These inside rings here, they're basically deadwood. So they're not going to translocate any of the chemical down to the roots where we need to kill. We've got to kill the roots in order to kill the tree. So we just take the syringe, and probably best to, if you got a little bit of a high spot, you just start up here and it'll flow down a little bit. You just treat it down, and if you have several stems, you need to treat each stem. And I just, for the purposes of making sure I get a good kill, so that's about 2 milliliters there, and we got about a 3.5-inch, four-inch stump here, so I'll put a little bit on that. That soaks in really quick. We'll go to each one of these multiple stems and treat each one, so that they all get a good treatment. If you don't treat every stem, you're very likely going to have, and we've got all these little ones, so I'll just dab a little bit on each one of those. Otherwise, we would have very likely have some suckers come up that we don't want. We only want to have to do it once. Now these that are kind of got left, we can do kind of a basal bark treatment, but you need to get that onto those just like you do all the others. So that's really the application method. It's really quite simple, and it goes fairly fast. You just have to kind of keep up with the sawyers and the swampers and everything. So you got 2 or 3 man crew, they can do the sawing and the swamping. Otherwise, you can high stump them and then come back a day later, cut them and treat them. We've been doing some research on that, and it seems to be just as effective as if you were to cut it and treat it quickly. So when we talk about high stumping, we're basically just going to cut up higher, and that will allow us then to come back and make another cut down low. So we've got to get through all this brush to get to the trunk. Then we can make another quick cut down low and get everything cut off, and then we can treat down low. The other option, we're still doing some trials to research whether or not how effective it is to treat the high stump and kill it this way. If you do that, again, you'd have to treat each one of those stumps, so there's a lot more that you have to do. But this is an option that may work in a fence line where you can't get down because you got the wire in the way. You may be able to cut off at the top of the tree. The jury's still out on how effective that is at this point, but now we can come through and cut that down low and treat the stump. So this is what's called high stumping.